Right now, Donald Trump on top for the Republicans. He joins us now by phone. Good morning, Mr. Trump. Good to have you again with us this morning. You know, you've never actually faced voters before. Are you nervous?
Well, you have to be a little bit nervous. And, you know, I like to win, and I want to win for the country. I don't want to win for myself. And this is actually my first election night. I've gone through many election nights, but it was always for somebody else, George. This is a little bit different for me.
I'm sure it is. What worries you most?
Well, I just hope everybody is going to be able to get out and vote. It looks like we're going to be skirting the weather, so the weather is going to be okay. It won't start snowing until after everything is finished. So we just made it. That was a biggie. But it just, you know, I just hope everybody gets out and votes. We have the biggest crowds by far of anybody, including Sanders. And he is second, I will say that. But we have the biggest crowds. And we have, I think, the most enthusiasm. And you know, you have to see these rallies are like love fests. And I really believe they're going to go out and vote. You know, the theme is Make America Great Again, and this is the chance. And I'm self-funding my campaign. I'm the only one that's doing that, George. I'm putting up my money. Nobody else is doing that. And I think that's a big difference, and a lot of people like that. But there's a great enthusiasm in those rooms and all over the state and all over every state. If, you know, when you look at New Hampshire, you saw the polls that just came down there with his, I guess, a 25-point lead. But in Iowa, I really think we're going to do really well. I hope we're going to do well, and we're going to find out soon
enough. Staying
we just got
power.
The endorsement
You're staying
of Jerry
power
Falwell,
so
Jr.,
many people.
Which has been a great endorsement.
Sorry yes, about that. Your staying power has surprised so many people so far. But yeah, I was wondering what your response is to Chris Christie, who was up in New Hampshire last night, and he said Donald will take himself down over time. I think we might have lost Mr. Trump right there.
Yes, I have you.
Did you get that?
Yes.
Sorry.
Yes, I hear you fine.
What was your response to Chris Christie? He says you're going to take yourself down over time.
Well, you know, people have said that I wasn't going to run, and then they said, well, if I ran, he'd just going to have fun and he'd leave, and now I'm in first place by a lot. And, you know, Chris took himself down when he did the George Washington Bridge, and he took himself down when he's rated number 50 out of 50 in New Jersey. I mean, it's the 50th worst state, meaning it's last. And, you know, he shouldn't be talking like that. I'm surprised that he would talk like that because I know him, and I guess he used to be a friend until this all happened. But no, I think it's been just the opposite, and I would be very surprised that somebody like that would say it. I mean, he's got enough problems, and he's doing very poorly in the polls. So I am surprised that he would have said that. My life has been a life of success. It's been a life of winning. It's been a life of making great deals. It's been a life of, you know, I've achieved tremendous success in so many different ways. And for somebody to say that is, you know, obviously not doing very well right now is pretty unusual, I think.
And you'll be facing the voters for the first time tonight. We're going to be talking to your sons in the next half hour. Thanks for joining us this morning. We'll be talking to you later as well.